First tonight, a Lexington man says he had no choice but to save the pilot of a plane crash. Thanks for joining us. I'm Paul Folger.
And I'm Jessica Schambach. That crash happened last Thursday when the pilot tried to make an emergency landing near Purcell. Only on 5 tonight, Amanda Guerra talked to the man who helped save his life. Amanda?
And Jessica, the pilot is Thomas Studham. Right now, he is in fair condition at OU Medical Center. And the man who saved him is shrugging off anyone who calls him a hero.
I mean, I didn't have no choice. I knew he needed help, and I had to get there as fast as I could, any way I could.
Sterling Moby was just on the other side of this bridge when a friend ran up and told him a plane crashed in the river.
And I said, well, was there people there? And he said, there's nobody around.
Sterling took off running.
We went in right here, crossed and went to that side because we knew we couldn't get to him the other way because of all the bushes.
From here, Sterling could see the outline of the plane and within 10 minutes reached the pilot, Thomas Studham.
I looked at his back was tore up.
Studham told Sterling his plane clipped these power lines, then smashed into the river only 2 feet deep. Sterling says when he got there, Studham was lying on the beach, but Sterling wanted him back in the water.
You know, I just felt like if I took the weight off of him, because he's a big man, you know. He's probably 230 pounds or so. I just knew if I got the weight off of him, he might be all right. Then he started coughing up black blood, you know, so I really knew then he was in trouble.
Sterling, sitting in the river, held the pilot against his chest.
But I talked to him, just kept him, you know, alert where he was looking at me.
And after nearly 40 minutes of waiting, emergency crews finally showed up.
Well, I was glad they were there. It was over with. This guy, hopefully he's going to make it. You know?
And it looks like he's going to. Now get this, Sterling has 2 ruptured discs in his neck. He says by the time he got to the pilot, he was in so much pain, he thought both of them were going to need a helicopter to get out. Live tonight in the studio, Amanda Guerra, Eyewitness News 5.
And tonight, federal investigators are still trying to figure out why that plane went down in the first place.